gutter, would you have read it that way? That was her response to questions about the perceived sexual innuendo implication in the president's tweet from earlier today, where he was personally attacking a sitting New York Democratic Senator, Kirsten Gillibrand. Let me bring my panel in. And Maeve Reston, I'm starting with you. Mind in the gutter. I mean, listen, I know she has an audience of one. What did you make of that response?
I mean, that's absurd. Every single one of us interpreted that remark as having sexual innuendo. There really isn't any other way to interpret it. To say that it was about campaign finance reform coming from Donald Trump is just ridiculous. But I mean, what was she going to say in response to that? That's the tricky role that she's in, is that she has to explain why Donald Trump would go after, a sitting U.S. senator in these kind of very personal, crude terms. And there's not really any way to explain that, Brooke.
It's like, I jotted down, Mark, some of the key phrases she used the first time she was asked the question. Campaign contributions in D.C., drain the swamp, broken government, special interests, all as a response to a question about sexual innuendo in the president's tweet.
Well, Brooke, and then she went on to say that Kirsten Gillibrand is basically influenced by every nickel or penny that is given to her by a campaign contributor. Now, we've all heard stories about folks who are influenced in Congress. I haven't heard anything about Kirsten Gillibrand being somebody who is influenced and sells her vote in order for campaign contributions. But what also was really frustrating is when she talked about fake news and asked a question about authoritarian regimes, basically using the Trump language to tamp down the free press in their own country. And quite frankly, CNN has been affected by that, as our own reporting with our colleagues overseas. It's outrageous that she would sit up there and be attacking the media at the same time where we don't always get the full truth from that podium.
Yes, and I'm glad you made the point on that, but I just really want to hammer home on this tweet, and just so we're on the same page, Alan, will you put the tweet up that we keep talking about, this Trump tweet, just so people watching at home know what we're talking about? And it's this key phrase in parentheses, which is what Sarah Sanders had been asked about, where he's talking about Senator Gillibrand begging for campaign contributions not so long ago, mid-tweet, parentheses, and would do anything for them. Former Pennsylvania Senator Republican Rick Santorum with us. And Senator Santorum, I just would love to hear your thoughts on this. What do you make of that tweet?
Well, I certainly read it the way that that everybody else read it. Unfortunately, could it be read somewhere else? Yes, it could. But I'm not sure that wasn't part of the president's point, to make it somewhat ambiguous and use language that he's used before. So these kinds of tweets are a certainly something that Donald Trump does a lot of, something that I think I've uniformly said I wish he wouldn't do. And we've got very important things that are being decided today. We've got a tax bill that may be finalized here in the next day or two. We have a very important Alabama special election. And here we are talking about the president's attacking a senator and using terms that could be certainly read as sexual innuendo. And I just, particularly in this environment, it's the president continuing to disrupt himself as well as the entire news cycle, and
he's tweeting about those other things, to be fair, but he's also tweeting these very personal attacks specifically on this female senator. Maria, your thoughts?
What was interesting to me, I said at the beginning that I thought it was horrendous right before the press briefing, and that to me it was clear, as to it is to so many others, that he was implying that she was a whore, and how disgusting that was coming from the president of the United States. But to what Sarah Sanders said in terms of how she was trying to defend this and saying that if you think that, then your mind is in the gutter. Well, okay, so maybe our minds are in the gutter, but they're in the gutter because Donald Trump is in the gutter, and we have followed him there because he has been there all of his life. He has objectified women for the last 30 years. He has used misogynistic terms to talk about women, and he has insulted women, from as far back as we can remember, when he was on all of these radio shows bragging about all of his sexual conquests. And so you know, you'll forgive the American people when they have a president of the United States who is a self-professed and bragging about committing sexual assault, and we have that on tape in his own words. So if she believes that, then she needs to look no further than who her boss is.
And now you have these women, we you know, they came forward during the 16 election, now
right.
They're back, you know, publicly again accusing the president of you know, forcibly kissing and groping and a lot more than that. And
exactly.
So they want Congress to investigate this. And Senator, back over to you, because on that point, you know, Sarah Sanders was asked about this and asked, you know, if it's all not true, why not support this call for this congressional investigation? Do you think, Senator, it is worth Congress's time to do this?
Actually, I don't believe this is the proper role to Congress to take into what are sexual transgressions of a president.
Why not?
And I say that,
why not?
I say that as someone who voted for President Clinton's impeachment, but it wasn't on his sexual transgressions. It was on the fact that he committed perjury. And we were very clear about that. We said, look, you know, the president, we don't approve of what the president did in the White House. We don't approve of the president's behavior, which was well known and well documented and well tolerated by very many Democrats. But we said the role of Congress is to look at whether the president is committing high crimes and misdemeanors. And while groping is a horrendous and terrible thing, I don't think it reaches high crimes and misdemeanors. And so that's where I think we've reset the standard here. That all of my Democratic friends who are now crying how horrible this president was and what a cad he is, we're defending Bill Clinton doing, in my opinion, much worse things in the Oval Office.
Maria, does he have a point?
He does in that, you know, I will say, and many Democrats. Have said this, that they are rethinking how they are looking at how presidents
can behave.